people, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, you remember yesterday I did the video on the businessman by the name of Roger Chang, who they find him, or they found his body down there in Dover, which is apparently the Dover that's in the border of Portland and St. Mary, right? In the original video, I thought it was the Dover with him go race car, but apparently that is not the case. Now, people, the day following this event, this sad event, especially for his family, some details have come out that has made this whole case look spooky, right? Now, before I go any further, I know there's no shortage of Simple Simons out there, so unfortunately, I have to add this disclaimer, because common sense isn't that common. Obviously, I'm no investigator. I don't work for no police investigation unit. I don't work for Crime Stop or what them call them, CSI and all those organizations that them are firing. But people, this look very spooky considering who Roger Chang was and the area that fall under his umbrella. People, Roger Chang was the president of the New Kingston Citizens Association. In other words, that is the group of people who is a group of residents, right? And any little thing going on in the New Kingston area, for example, anything we concern the citizens them. For example, if you ever build something in our community and the residents and feel like say it will bother them or cause them some kind of problem, the New Kingston Citizens Association will be the people them who would have pushed back, right, or pushed back against it. So of course, in New Kingston, you have a lot of developments and a lot of developers. And as I did in my previous video, back in when I talk about the big case with the $100 million apartment to get lit down, or that is going to get lit down, you have a lot of unruly developers. And the New Kingston Citizens Association would be the rivals to those developers, right? So anytime somebody come in, they want to build on, if the residents don't like it, these people are who would push back against it. Roger Chang was the president of that organization. That is spooky for a number of reasons. Now, going back to the case about that $100 million apartment. Remember, in that video, I said, me don't know how this I go, because $100 million and a little bit of money. Now again, I have to emphasize to the Simple Simons out there, I'm not saying that the two of them, link, and the people them who get the $100 million apartment lit down, send man to go take out Roger Chang. I'm not saying nothing like that, right? All I'm saying is this looks spooky, because remember, the $100 million apartment is the biggest case we can think of. But what other people don't realize is New Kingston in general have whole heap of apartments that are currently in disputes, right? And if you look on your screen right now, you would see a statement from the politician, the MP, Julian Robinson, saying even just at the gun, right, he was having he was debating against or debating our property development in New Kingston. So this is the man who anytime no kind of foolishness go on or the residents feel like they might get shortchanged, you know, nice problem, disturbance, etc., he's the man who pushed back against it. So just at the gun, he was involved in another toss up. Or not even a tussle, you know what I mean? He might do his job, which is standing up for the residents. So, not just the $100 million case, but there are lots of cases out there where Roger Chang would have been the man as the president to push back and say, no, this can't work, that can't work. Now, people understand this. Developers in Jamaica in general, no for them are bad, man. I'm sorry, there's no way to put it. There's no nice way to put it. A lot of these developers in Jamaica, as I said in my original video, in that $100 million apartment thing, I told you, one of the quickest way to lose a life in Jamaica is to get involved in a housing development. Who remember that? Who remember that video? I said one of the quickest way to lose your life in Jamaica is to get involved in a housing development in any way, shape or form, whether you are build or whether you want to stop them from build. People, enough bad man, enough 90 octanes, enough 87 to get that one money run going at development, because it is very there's not a lot of, even though on paper there are rules and orders, but in reality it's a cowboy business. Enough of these developers are cowboys, wild wild west. And people, if you push back against them certain way and stop them from quote unquote eat our food and stop them from do this, or you are the reason for this, strange and spooky things will happen to you. Now again, for the simple Simons out there, I'm not saying me know nothing for a fact and me have no inside information. I'm just telling you, this look extremely spooky that Roger Chang, the president of the New Kingston Citizens Association, the man who is the leader of the organization that pushes back against all these developers, right, in the area, all of a sudden, this happened to him. Because the story goes, him and a female roll out, gone to Portland. You don't know, you look at Sunday Flex, right, gone to Portland with a female, and they actually know who the female is, right? Them describe her as having a tattoo on her right mid-thigh, short curly ear, and her name is Khadisha McKenzie, otherwise known as Dee Dee, right? So, he look like Mr. Chin, Mr. Chang, make a little flex with a little, you know, little young atty-atty, and then them roll out and they reach him. Now here's the thing, people, them can't find the car and them can't find the girl. And all of the wounds they went get, all of the stab wounds they went get was in them back. People, watch this now. They can't find the car and they can't find the girl. If that girl don't turn up under the same circumstances where Roger Chang get found, it's safe to assume she have a role to play in this. Again, I know Simple Simon are going to ask me if I'm dead, right? But people, that's a fair assumption at this point. If something happened to she at this point, because remember, now, one day passed now, so if Mandy rushed them and she'd have to take care of herself and run away, then by now she'd already turn up on police station and say, you know, see this happened to me, and see one bruiser, and see this and this, then can't find her. Right, so she gone and Kira gone, right? People, that female, if she didn't turn up in a similar circumstances like Roger Chang, in my opinion, she have something to do with it. She probably helped set up the man, people. All of the wound them in the man back. Now, in the most mean to say, as she actually stabbed him up, right? But some kind of setup go on them, set up the man, people. Because this little man here, listen, I don't know nobody doing them spare time, right? I don't put my neck on block for no man, especially no strange man, I don't know. But based on what I've heard so far, Roger Chang and nobody now have nothing outside of being the president of the New Kingston Citizen Association. Him and nobody now have nothing. And like I say, him in the streets are push badness or indeed violate someone. All of Roger Chang's problems have to do with housing and development, right? So it's fair to assume that any serious anymore will come from out of these developments. Now, you might say, well, sir, please support the girl, Robbie Mars, people. No robbery now go down, so. No girl now go care, go with man, go to Portland, go Robbie Mars self, and then stop him up in my back, and then throw him in my back, throw him in the water, and then drive with him care. That case is a cut and clear case for your police. That case is a cut and clear case. Where she rub him off? The car? Where think she the one? The Suzuki Swift? People, come on. Sorry, the Suzuki SUV we're missing? Come on, people. That's the getaway car. That gun, them probably burning up or something. You think them go through all this to take one car? You think the girl went through all that, make him drive with her to Portland to take away the car from him? People, this is not for the car, right? I see some people are saying, no, maybe them the one thief the car. Nobody now go through that for thief the car. And them amount of stuff they in them back, people, this is personal. That is no robbery, right? Robbery no go down like that. So first thing we need to do is find out what go on with that female. Where she at? What kind of condition she in? Right? We need she to piece this thing together, because if she alright, she have some serious questions to answer. Some serious questions to answer. And again, as me say, the $100 million case, the $100 million apartment is the big one that stand out, right? But there are many cases in the New Kingston area where property people and property developers and residents go toe-to-toe over construction, right? And Roger Chang would have been the man, the head of that. He would have been the man who is the face of it, who put up the most resistance, and as a, you know, he was the resident's voice then, so to speak, right? And now that something like this happened to him, I'm just saying it looks spooky, people. That's all I'm saying. So, a lot of times these things happen, and then I come out and I say, yo, that looks spooky. Right, and people, Simple Simon jump up, hey, did it? Hey, did it? Oh, you know that, hey, did it? And then it come out down the road, say, I got one, and people that message me. Then I start get 100 messages. So, you know, sir, a true thing that talk. So, I don't know. People, the whole case that, I really, really hope, say, this is not a case of somebody who was standing up for the resident, doing him job, and some look a crooked developer take him out. In some ways, I actually hope it's a simple case of robbery. Even though it's very, very unlikely, but I hope that's the case. Because it would be really tragic if in Jamaica, if in a place like New Kingston, residents can't stand up for themselves without having to worry that something happened like that, right? That would just go to show you how far criminality has penetrated, because the Golden Triangle for years, New Kingston for years, was seen as a safe spot. But now, nowhere in Jamaica is safe. Nowhere at all. You see how far they carry the man go? You see how far this happened to Roger Chang? All the way to Portland. People, hopefully we hear some more about this case. But the number one thing right now is that female. We need the police for holding on on that female. So, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.